everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Football in the upper Midwest, Spartan Stadium, the tallest structure in East Lansing, consistently ranks among the NCAA's top 20 schools in attendance. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. Sends it sailing downfield. Seniors are throwing on the home jerseys for the final time in their career. For these kids, an awfully emotional time. You always want to go out in style and get a win. See what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Gives it to the back. Runs outside for a nice gain. Moody gets 7 yards on the play.
That'll bring up second and three.
It's second and three. Ball on the 21. Pitches back. And he's still on his feet. He's to the 40, the 50. At the 30, to the 20. Tackle at about the 13.
Now that is exactly how you draw up the option. When this offense is executing the option effectively, they are a tough team to stop from moving the ball.
First and 10 following that big run. He's tackled at about the 5 yard line. The kind of guy that could end up with some national honors, because right now he's leading the conference statistically. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Quick strike to the back, no good. From their own 18-yard line, second down.
Pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
was the intended target on the play. That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
On third down, the defense... The last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this drive.
From the 48-yard line, it's second down. Minnesota up 7 points. Here's an opening. He's at the 30 for the 20, the 10. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him with a first and goal. He's been tearing it up in the running game. That carry puts him over 100 yards.
What you like is how clever he is at allowing the play to take shape before he makes his move. That shows vision and maturity.
First down. They've got the defense on their heels now. It's first and goal. It's power against power right now on the field. Both teams have their jumbo sets out there. Touchdown, Golden Gophers. Not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. He's to the 40. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? You better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
First and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. Midfield. Oh, picks up about three with that catch. They'll bring him down at the 49. A 1 yard gain by the halfback. The 49-yard line. It's third down. Room around the corner, and he's tackled in the open field. And now he's up over 1,000 yards on the ground for the year.
Just staying healthy an entire year should be considered success for a running back. But there is no doubt that this guy has been a large part of this team's success. Spot. The big key was the offensive line giving the ball carrier room to get upfield.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 38. He makes it to the 38-yard line.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
He's scrambling, decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. And they make the stop right around the 16-yard line. So with that run, they pick up another first.
This is a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 16-yard line. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
10th play of the drive. To his receiver, touchdown. And they had a tough time defending that one.
But Brad, one of the things that did.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. At the 30. Across midfield. And he's tackled at the 44. Minnesota's offense is really looking dangerous so far in this one, Kirk. I mean, what's the defense going to do to slow them down?
I think you have to start somewhere. And that somewhere, I think, is stopping the run. You have to load up, take your chances, put extra numbers in the box. Once you stop the run, that can allow you to put some pressure on their passing game. But right now, they're not stopping the run or the pass.
Now he tries to buy some time. Throws to the middle. And he is drilled at the 20-yard line. From the 20-yard line, it's first down. Minnesota is up by a touchdown. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
That's a nice job by the quarterback to pitch the ball, and it got him a first down.
Touchdown reception, he's now got 10 this year.
We expected him to be a prime time target today, and so far he has been. Great catch for the touchdown.
So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll see the same result on this one?
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive. And until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
And he's taken down at the 26-yard line. Second down and 9 to go. Ball on their own 26. Pushed out of bounds around the 33-yard line. We played one quarter. The Golden Gophers in front, 21-7. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Down at the 36. From their own 36-yard line, first down. The senior makes the catch. He's knocked out of bounds. Get around the 50. and 5. Ball on the 45. Bunched up tight defensively. Quick throw, and he's got his man again. And they push him out right around the 12-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 12-yard line. Yardage. 6 yards there on the counter. And this is the 9th play of the current drive. They'll drop him for a loss. So we're looking at another third down here. Here's a screen pass, gets it to the back. Touchdown, Spartans! So they go to the air, and they come away with 6, Kirk.
And Brad, I got to tell you, that's not an easy thing to do there. The defenses nowadays are so tough when you get inside the red zone.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the 3. Gets out to about the 21.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer. And that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown. The other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. 5 wide receivers in the formation. Going long. And he's tackled at the 37. And a great catch downfield. Now it's first and 10 with a defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Minnesota is up a score. And he has it on the corner. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. Got some open field. He's taken down at the 26. From the 26-yard line. First down. He's going to try and scramble. Now he's going to run and watch out. Steps out of bounds at the 11-yard line. Offense lines up in a 5-wide set, and the defense anticipating pass here. Finds a man. Touchdown.
That's a positive for the passing game. It was absolutely the right call in that situation.
you think about the challenges these two teams are facing, on one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Looking for the corner. He's to the 40. Tackle around the 48-yard line. So it's first and 10 after the big run. And he's stopped behind the line.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
That makes it second and 14.
He's at the 30. He's tackled at the 15-yard line.
Well, I tell you, these guys have some skill players who can make things happen. They picked up an enormous amount of real estate on that play.
So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. Newsom gets the call again. And he hits him hard at the 4. The Spartans call a timeout. That's their second of the half. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
This defense not wanting to give an inch here. They'll bring him down around the 2-yard line. They're at the 2. Second down. Throws, and he's got a man. Touchdown. And that makes it 3 scoring tosses for him.
This quarterback is going to continue to tear him up until they get some pressure on him.
They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20. Across the 30. He's taken down at the 32-yard line. Golden Gophers right now are getting the play out of their quarterback that they expected, maybe even better than they expected. And now, as we get near halftime, there's going to have to be some adjustments made on the other side of the ball.
Well, the defense has got to be happy we're getting close to halftime so they can go back to the drawing board and try to figure out a way to slow down this quarterback. I think that more often than not, you look back to the first half and you think about, okay, let's eliminate this, this, and this, and let's maybe try a completely different way of trying to attack him. In my opinion, they've got to take some chances and be more aggressive in trying to put pressure on him.
What they've done so far hasn't worked. Minnesota is up 7. Moody gets a carry right side, and they get nice yardage on that run. It's 2nd and 6. Ball on the 45-yard line. And he's knocked out immediately after the catch.
That makes it 1st and 10.
Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. The Golden Gophers will use their first time out of the half. Yeah. lets it go. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. For Morrow, that's his second touchdown catch.
Well, it's obvious the coach wanted to get him involved in the game plan. It looks like it was a pretty smart move, too.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Gross ball him back and got his man. And down he goes at the 41-yard line. First down. Nice run up the middle. Newsom gets 6 yards on the carry. Second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage. And he was pretty much stuffed on that run.
You know what? That was just a nice job by the defense in stopping him before he could get going and build up momentum. Defenders and allow his covered receivers some room to improvise.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Little handoff. And they make the stop at the 30. Nice gain for the halfback.
That time they kept it on the ground with the counter play. The blocking was great up front, and the tailback was able to get into the open field and do some special things.
From their own 30-yard line, first down. Runs outside for a nice gain. The misdirection play gets him 4 yards. Taken down at about the 41. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 41. Up the middle for a nice gain. Moody gains around 6 yards on the run. Makes his way out to about the 15.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 15. He's under pressure. The 10. What a play, and that is first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
First and goal from the one, looking to punch this one in. It's power against power right now on the field. Both teams have their jumbo sets out there.
Touchdown, Golden Gophers.
Nice run and a score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach.
Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
The running back gets two on the carry.
With the defensive line neutralizing the blocks, these linebackers are able to come up and make plays in the holes.
From their own 27-yard line, second down. Here's a throw that's almost picked. It's third down, eight to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. And on the throw, he caught it. Brought down at the 49-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. So they get about three on the draw.
That makes it second and eight.
And now they're faced with another third and long as they try to convert and move those chains again. He steps out right around the 42-yard line. They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
The ruling on the field will stand. He caught it.
The only thing left to say about this play is that was an excellent catch.
Jackson to punt. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. See this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game.
see if they can do it again.
He's got to throw it in a hurry. Tackle made to the 23-yard line. From their own 23-yard line, it's second down. He's on the run. Gets nailed, and it's intercepted. They're not done yet.
Great job here by the defender breaking on the ball and taking it to the house. Man, those pick sixes can really hurt an offense and have a lasting impact.
He makes the PAT. Michigan State ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 10. And he's taken down at the 16. Anderson's kept his cool after a bad first half. Kirk, and they're right in this thing.
You know, even when his team was down, he just never seemed to panic. He was cool in the huddle. He got his teammates on the same page and has really just taken command of this offense. I think he's been unbelievable. His talent, I think, is through the roof. But I think it's his mental toughness is what really puts him into a category all by himself.
He's taken down at the 30-yard line. Don't leave yet, folks. We still got one more quarter to go. Minnesota's in front by 14. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. There's a strike complete. To the 20, to the 10, and he's tackled at the 3-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. That's a great tackle at the 3. Defense stacked in tight here. Touchdown, Minnesota! Three rushing touchdowns on the ground today for this young man.
If I were the head coach of this football team, I would give him the ball at least 30 times a game.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Inbounds to make a nice catch.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 36.
This quarterback is tough as nails. Right? He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel. Almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Complete. He's got room to work. Tackle at the 40.
What a relief it is for a quarterback to know that he's got a receiver like this who can step up when he needs him on third down.
They'll bring him down the 25-yard line.
Quarterbacks just love this scenario. He had his man one-on-one on a corner route versus man coverage, and you just saw it. It results in an easy first down.
First and 10, ball on the 25. Fires out to his receiver. He's tackled around the 16-yard line. That's his fourth touchdown pass of the game.
Well, what we have right now is a quarterback who's very comfortable with his offense. He believes in his system, and the coaches and players believe in him. You couldn't ask for a better situation.
I'm kind of surprised. These guys are still losing after the touchdown. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Great concentration to pull it in. And down he goes at the 31. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. Makes his way to about the 22.
That makes it second and two.
Just under three to go in regulation. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Tackled after a decent pickup. Michigan State's going to take their first time out of the half.
That'll make it second and four.
Pitches it. Gets out to around the six. The Spartans use their second timeout. Minnesota looking to make this a three-score game. He gets out to about the six-yard line. The Spartans are going to have to call their third and final timeout. Stop at about the 3-yard line. Here we go. Third and goal from the 3-yard line. Let's see if they try to pound it in here. Both teams have their goal line sets on the field. And he has it on the corner. And he's taken down around the 1-yard line. Under a minute left in the game. Touchdown, Golden Gophers. I'm sure there are a lot of fans out there hoping for a miracle, but I seriously doubt we're going to see one today. And he tackles him hard at the 34. From their own 34-yard line, second down. Straight run, and he's brought down in the backfield. The Golden Gophers taking their first time out of the half.
They've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Davis is back deep to return. Calls for the fair catch. Resulted in six. Anderson with a nice play fake. He wants it all. Going long. Brought down at the 17-yard line. Anderson, the star of the game, Kirk. It's as simple as that. He played a great game. The whole team played a great game, and they won it. That's the important part.
Yeah, Brad, he had an excellent game, and really kind of what we expected coming into today's game for him to be able to step up and show that he's one of the top players in the country, and he really didn't disappoint at all. While individual accolades are great, I'm sure he'll tell you the fact that his team came away with a victory is really the most important aspect of this game.